Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to TWF, and look at our main event tonight, Dick Pearsall.
Oh, Jacoby Jones, I have been waiting with this one, just like the TWFers out there in the audience, with bated breath. Man, oh man, Christian Black, watch your back.
Well, this is the Jackson Sports Academy, McClellan, California. This is a giant of a woman. This is the massive, monstrous competitor and challenger for the Women's Championship right here and now. And it's very rare that a champion is an underdog, but we have that situation in front of our faces here tonight. Andrea the Giant. Oh. Well, there's the graphic. I'm Jacoby Jones. I'm joined by Dick Pearsall. Who's going to win this thing?
This one is going to be the classic brute strength, size versus speed, quickness, and guile. I don't know, Jacoby Jones. I heard Andrea the Giant has a little crush on you. Just what I heard.
Well, I certainly hope not. I'm intimidated, and I'm sitting 75 feet away. But there's a reason Vikki Vanity has been women's champion in TWF for approaching 1 year's time. She finds a way to win. She defeated Crystal for that title, got herself victories in several rematches. Vikki Vanity has the people behind her, and it's going to take one monstrous, epic performance this evening to hang on to that 10 pounds of women's gold. Of course, our main event here tonight, this evening, is a Lumberjack match featuring Christian Black versus Black Assassin. It all comes to a head, but kicking things off is the females. Vikki Vanity, very skilled in the squared circle. A heart the size of this building, but will it be enough?
Well, tell you what, Jacoby Jones, Vikki Vanity has a mountain to climb, and that mountain to climb happens to be named Andrea the Giant.
Andrea the Giant from the Utah area of the United States. Vikki Vanity resides in the Reno area, so TWF has people from all over clamoring to be a part of this big match, of this big Real Mania environment, but you can't take your eyes off the two men dressed in black who accompanied Andrea the Giant to ringside.
Exactly. Keep your eye on those two henchmen and a record crowd watching these two females lock it up here at Real Mania 11.
Well, that might be a mistake.
Yeah, that
Vikki thrown on her butt by Andrea the Giant. No surprise there. Andrea, though, misses the big shot with the right hand, and look at Vikki retaliate.
Well, that's the speed factor of Vikki Vanity. Very smart right now. She's got her competitor, her opponent in the corner. Work her over. Why not?
Well, there's a chop moments ago, but look at the power. Look at the brute strength of Andrea the Giant taking care of business early on, and this is what we all thought would happen, drilling that shoulder into the midsection.
Andrea the Giant could literally shoulder block the champion into next week.
Yep, she has the ability to do so. We've seen her compete with the men many times here in TWF. Today, challenging for that women's title. There's an Irish whip. Vikki very hard into that far corner there.
And mentioned a very coveted women's title in TWF.
Well, once again, sidesteps the contact, avoids it. Vikki Vanity, stick and move. Oh, big chop.
Echoes throughout the arena. Uh-oh, I think she pissed the big woman off.
And the crossbody doesn't move her at all. Here's a pinfall attempt. Vikki somehow flails her arms, flails her legs, and gets herself out of trouble. Andrea the Giant, we're talking 6'5". We're talking 280 pounds, and she's a woman. There is no woman I have ever seen in the wrestling business who approaches that kind of size and strength.
Trying to wrestle like a barn. This woman's ginormous.
Vikki Vanity now hoisted easily up in the air. Look at this. Making her think about it. The blood rushing to the skull. Oh, big body slam.
And when you're that strong, you can do something like that. You can lift up your opponent like she's nothing. Hold her up there for a few seconds. Ooh. And then when you feel like it, slam her down their mat. But it wasn't enough to keep it down for the three count. The champ ain't going out like that.
Well, Vikki Vanity has found a way to beat stronger opponents before. She won the title from Crystal. She defended it successfully a couple times. Uh-oh. Oh, but how can any human being, man or woman, survive that?
You called it. The way she won the title was beating a big, much bigger challenger. But here we go. This challenge right here in front of her. This is huge. This is just, I mean, you'd say big, but this is big, big.
Trying to clear the cobwebs, trying to get some blood flowing back to the brain. Oh, and smushed like a bug. Vikki down one more time. This methodical smash mouth pace is exactly tailored to the style of Andrea the Giant, and she is soaking in every second of it.
All the booze from the 300 plus crowd here.
400 plus.
Nice. But I'll tell you one thing.
One more time, hard into the buckles.
The champion Vikki Vanity would be well served to break the game plan right now of Andrea the Giant. She's doing exactly what she wants to do. Vikki Vanity's got to do something to shake this up.
Yeah, holding her chest in pain, obviously feeling every second of this punishment thus far. Oh, there we go. There's a shot. There's an opening. There's what she needed to do. Here's what she needed to accomplish. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, really? Really? Just as she starts that very innovative head scissor hanging from the top rope, the Iceman, one of these hangers on at ringside, plants an elbow onto Vikki Vanity and stops the move.
That could have done a lot of damage if she would have hung there. She could have cut off the flow of blood, bled their brain. That's the type of move that you need to beat a larger opponent like this. Put him in a sleeper hold. Use the cardio. Oh, what the heck?
No, I guess you're kidding me. Time. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? This is blatant.
Wow.
The referee's got no choice. This is Mikey Kamikaze and the Iceman trying to make a statement at Real Mania. And look at this. Here comes the cavalry. It's Tyson Reigns. Oh.
A couple of boys backstage had just about enough watching this nonsense. Oh, of Vikki Vanity getting the old screw job here. They put their nose in, put a stop to it right away.
We've got ourselves a quandary, a cat's game. What the hell's the referee going to do?
And you weren't invited here.
I want a piece of him.
You want a piece of him?
I want a piece of him. Give me him.
I smell box office.
This is my match! What are you gonna do? Come on, hey!
Okay, well, the official ruling has been made. This is now a six-person tag. If those guys want to stick their nose where it doesn't belong, they're going to have to fight to earn their keep here in TWF. And for once, I think that Jake made a good decision.
How about that, Jacoby Jones? Once again, the fans show up to see one thing, and whoop, they see something completely different.
Well, officially now, it is now Vikki Vanity. Oh, beautiful, shining wizard kick to the side of the skull. Vikki Vanity, Ryan McQueen, and Tyson Reigns versus Andrea the Giant, the Iceman, and Mikey Kamikaze. A six-person tag. However, anyone can fight anyone. Anyone can face anyone in this environment. It's not that that watered-down, only women versus women kind of stuff, and men versus men. And wow, Ryan McQueen, tremendous athletic potential, just got shoved on his butt.
What an eclectic group of wrestlers. Wow, Tyson Reigns, very agile. Is it still Andre the Giant? He's calling someone else out.
Oh, that's the Iceman.
Boy, he's taking on a big boy.
Yeah, that guy's over three bills, I can tell. Tags in Mikey Kamikaze, the high flyer of the bunch.
All right, multiple tags. Guys going in, guys going out. Are we stunned now?
I guess we are.
I guess we got our two opponents going to lock it up.
Well, Ryan McQueen, Tyson Reign, and Vikki Vanity all have a background in the Reno area. They all are alumni from that region, looking to make a splash here at Rio Mania. Watching the back of Vikki Vanity miss a clothesline now. Oh,
wow.
Beautiful back elbow by this young rookie.
They call the biggest little wrestler around, huh?
Wow.
This goes Reno.
Leapfrog. Oh.
One more. Whoa.
Absolutely, tremendously executed by Ryan McQueen. Leapfrog from the front, from the back, and a drop kick right in the mush.
Young Ryan McQueen is opening up a few eyes here in the TWF.
Oh, stinger splash in the corner. Kamikaze takes the belly-to-belly. There's the cover. Only a two count, but Ryan McQueen turning some heads, showing the world the athletic potential, the athleticism. This kid's a real athlete for sure.
Ryan McQueen is wrestling like a house on fire right now. There we go. I was about to say, Mikey Kamikaze got to do something to turn the tide. He did. That's for sure. Oh, what a falling out.
Spinning heel kick in the corner. Catches Ryan McQueen right in the face. Flips back over the top rope. Lands on his feet. I alluded to his high-flying ability earlier. Mikey Kamikaze. He's been doing this quite a bit longer than Ryan McQueen. But both of their styles very comparable. Yeah, and just choking him out. That's a blatant choke. If you're flying all over the ring like that, Mikey Kamikaze, why do you need to choke the guy out behind the referee's back?
Because
what is the need for that?
Because it's effective.
Okay.
It definitely decimates your opponent.
Well, Queen's down, shoulders on the canvas, able to lift them up before the three count. You're just joining us. This started as a women's title match. It materialized into a six-person tag. That's where we stand now.
Exactly, and how upset is Andrea the Giant? She had a chance to walk out with 10 pounds of women's gold around her waist, all for naught.
Oh, there's a tag. There's a much-needed tag to Tyson Reign. Here we go. Here we go. We've seen him in TWF a few times before. Another guy with a ton of potential to make some waves. There it is, Michinoku Driver. Sit-out body slam. Both legs are cut in the hole, but only two.
Very slick moves put on by Tyson Reigns. Tyson Reigns is stronger, but still yet has the ability to fly around that ring.
What I like about this match is it's full of guys whose best days are yet to come. It's full of top prospects able to make some waves in TWF. Oh, there's a Macho Man, Randy Savage, 1987 double axe handle. How embarrassing would it be to lose to that? Put the shoulders up.
Oh, my God. Marty, I was in the time machine.
He watches a lot of old VHS tapes.
Oh,
Coliseum video.
Well, here we go. It definitely did the damage. More damage being done.
What a shot to the skull moments ago. Very lucky to stagger back into his own corner. And now here comes the Iceman. In my opinion, he's the X Factor in this matchup. He's the powerhouse who's a male. Oh no, oh no.
Oh my goodness.
Powerbomb. Super kick.
Nice super kick by McQueen. Very nice right on the kisser.
Well, and there's six people competing. Six people trying to do their best. Uh-oh. scissor kick executed very nicely by Kamikaze. There's a DDT by Vikki Vanity. Oh no. Oh no, turn around, turn around!
Oh my, oh, oh my!
Uranagi!
That's it.
Victory for Team Andrea. When the smoke cleared, there's your winner.
You have to tell her right now, you didn't win the belt.
Unfortunately for Andrea, if her two thugs wouldn't have hopped in the ring in the first place, maybe she would be walking away with the title right now. I'm just saying.
Very likely possibility.
I mean, it's a victory in front of a huge crowd at Rio Mania, but she is not the women's champion of TWF. That could be a temporary inconvenience, if you know what I'm saying.
Exactly. I think this story has not yet been written.
And Vikki Vanity leaves here with the women's title, but definitely a huge monkey on her back by being pinned by Andrea the Giant. Nice performance by all three of those individuals. Unfortunately, they came up short. He's already signed an autograph.
What about that? Jeez, don't let it go to your head, kid.
He's 7 minutes into his TWF career, and he's already signed an autograph. Good thing.
Handing out 8x10 glosses out in the parking lot afterwards. I guarantee it.
What a real meeting. Well, next week, we have got confirmation. We are heading to Fresno, and TWF champion Matt Fury, one-on-one, will take on Eddie Hernandez, the newest sensation here in TWF. You have got to watch this TV show next week.
I am loving that kid, Eddie Hernandez. Matt Fury's going to have his hands full.
Oh, you like live pro wrestling? Of course you do. You're watching this show, aren't you? Well, you need to get off your Xbox Live and show up May 18th, Salvation Army. 893 Lander Avenue in Turlock. Doors at 6:30. Bell time at 7. Be there.
It's an all-ages show, so bring Granny, bring the kiddies, bring them all. It'll be absolutely wall-to-wall entertainment, just like every TWF live show. You know, Jacoby Jones, the beautiful town of Turlock, California.
Man, Salvation Army getting a chunk of the proceeds, as always, at that venue. And then May 31st, the most unique show in TWF history. It's a tag team tournament on Friday, May 31st at FC Joy School, 6050 Watt Avenue in North Highlands. We're going to start at 1:30 p.m., right when they get out of school, and it's absolutely free. Anyone can show up, watch the festivities, and the tag tournament.
How great is that? You get to see live entertainment live. How often do you get to go see live entertainment for free? And not only that, it's the best damn entertainment in the freaking business. Am I right, Jacoby Jones?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Jake. Hi. It's a beautiful day in Fair Oaks. The birds are singing, the grass is green, and I've just been told by this guy right here that TWF has a very special opportunity, a huge one. All right, I'm going to ask you a question right now. What are your two favorite things? Go. All right, well, I'm going to guess that 99% of you said pro wrestling and zombies, right? I love them. That's where this guy comes in, right here. This is Jason. Pleased to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Jason is producing a film, a zombie movie, and guess who he asked to be the zombies? The TWFers. So why don't you tell the people watching the boob tube about your film?
Well, it is, as Jake has so wonderfully put, it is a zombie film. We intend to take it to the festival circuit once it is shot. It will be shot in and around the Sacramento area, preferably. We are scouting locations. We are in the middle of casting. We will be launching Indiegogo this summer for funding. And there's going to be a lot of developments, so please come and like the page. It will be an awesome movie. A lot of your TWFers, Jake here included, will be in the movie.
Else besides that, a good zombie or what?
Do I get
we'll
to
work
run?
On it.
Do I get to run?
These it's are going to be, a running be zombie?
Romero-style zombies.
Oh, so I get a...
Yeah, you're going to be like gross and all gross and everything.
That's good. It's going to take a lot to make this face look gross. That's almost, okay. We can worry about that later. But there's a Facebook page, Alone.
Yes.
A-L-O-N-E, Alone.
Yes, and please go like the page. We really need every bit of support we can get. Spread it to your friends, your family, your distant relatives, even the people you hate. You know, just please spread it to everybody.
Their money is good as our money. Anybody's money. Movies are one of the things that TWFers love. Movies are one of those things that draw you to wrestling in the first place. So it would be an absolute honor for all of us to be in a movie. So please support this, and we will check up with you over the weeks on the progress of this film. And definitely, once the process is complete, we will definitely air as much as we can. Because zombies, they're kind of cool, you know what I mean? Like puppy dogs and ice cream, you know, birthday parties. It's not so, pro wrestling and zombies go hand in hand like peanut butter and jelly, right? Right?
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
So this is an opportunity that we could not pass up. We want to thank Jason, and we want to be in that movie.
It definitely is happening.
Don't go back on your word.
Oh, it's not going to happen.
Knuckle sandwich. Knuckle sandwich is how we solve our problems. But yes, thank you very much, Jason. We're in Fair Oaks. We're enjoying the beautiful weather. Summertime is here. And more on this movie in the coming weeks, yo.
Well, it was last week on this television show. We thought we were going to see BH Brain's Personal Choice versus Stephen the Beast Smith. And boy, were we wrong, Dick Pearsall. Dry gulched, jumped from behind was Stephen the Beast Smith. The beatdown of four men at once.
Well, that's what you get from making a boom boom on another man's lawn.
They broke the briefcase over his face. They laid into him with everything but the kitchen sink. Oh, stuck on his skull there. Beast.
And then this is my favorite part. Just comes just one, two, three. It could be four, five, six, seven, 12. Man, oh man, BH Brain beat the hell out of the Beast. It was great.
For 4 years, that dude has been the bane of my existence. For the longest time, people thought I was the guy under the mask.
Christian Black, Real Mania, you're gonna get what's coming, man. You're gonna get what's coming. Just watch out! I'm telling you.
You can hide behind anything you want. You can attack me from places I didn't even know were places. But I will get you. I know you don't talk. And that's fine. Because time for talk is over. Real Mania, I'm challenging you, Black Assassin. Get your ass in this ring. Me and you, we're going to go one-on-one. We're going to settle this once and for all. I don't know what your problem is. I don't know how it even started, but I will finish it. You took my belts.
Black Assassin, you're dead!
The hatred runs deep.
For years, everybody thought it was me because it was me. Real Mania, Black Assassin, you're not going to get the whole fun-loving Christian Black that everybody knows and loves. You're going to get that guy that's rageful. That's vengeful. It's gonna hurt you.
Black Assassin wasn't having it. This is the X Factor. This is what we wondered about. Where would the assassin's head be?
No,
don't know what kind of pain you've experienced in your life, but it's going to be nothing compared to what I'm going to do to you then. That mask was a symbol of things. That used to be what I was about. Haven't you heard? I know you follow me. Always. And I mean always. Battle Black.
Oh, it is time. Months and months and months of frustration for Christian Black. This Black Assassin might be finally getting his.
Black Assassin is scarier than a fire-breathing dragon. Christian Black, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Lumberjack.
Here come the Lumberjacks, surrounding the ring, making sure there's no shenanigans. This is what it's come to in the feud between the Black Assassin and Christian Black. We were under the impression that Christian Black was the Black Assassin. Christian Black confirmed it. He confirmed he was the assassin all those years ago. But who's this guy then? Who is this assassin? Who is this Black Assassin who's been attacking Christian Black whenever he can, wherever he can, for about a year's time? I don't know. But I do know is there is a line. There's a trail of broken bodies in his wake ever since this version of the Assassin's debut in this company. Shot! Blackout! Blackout!
Christian Black taking no quarters on this, saying I have a taking attack to him. Wouldn't even come through the damn entranceway. Try culture with a chair. Wow!
It's time the Black Assassin got a taste of his own damn medicine. If you ask me, the Black Assassin's been doing stuff like that for almost a damn year, attacking Christian.
Christian Black took a page out of the Black Assassin's book right there and now has the upper hand because of it.
And Christian Black is destroying the Assassin. Destroying him. Payback's a bitch.
You want to stop me?
Oh. And these people want to see one more. And so do I. Christian Black is a blue-collar, working-class hero of these people. There is not a guy who has fought harder. Oh, dives into the midsection with the shoulder. There is not a guy who's fought harder and longer to get where he is than Christian Black. Much respect from everyone, and the Assassin's gonna have no chance, no choice, can't run away, can't hide in the shadows. He's thrown back in here.
Well, that's the key to a Lumberjack match. You saw right there, Black Assassin taking some punishment. He thought, take a powder, take a few moments.
Wait, 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 no Christians out there. They're not throwing him back in. They're punching him.
He got mugged. He got knocked out the wrong side of the ring. And right now, these guys are doing a grade A beatdown on one Christian Black.
The purpose is not to beat down the guy who's thrown to the outside. The purpose is to throw him back in so there's no escape. There's no run and hide. There's no excuses. And I see that being completely and totally butchered by some versions of our lumberjacks.
Well, you see the wrestlers that surround the ring. Some of the guys aren't the most, you know, let's just say upstanding citizens in the locker room. What do you think? They're not going to take a cheap shot when they get an opportunity?
Well, maybe Christian beat him a few months ago at a house show or something, and now they beat him up when he has no chance to defend himself? Is that what they do?
Probably cheat him out of a three count he was refereeing.
Nice snap suplex there. Pops those hips. Christian Black down, but only for a two count. But just like that, Christian Black surrenders the momentum. Just like that, the Black Assassin's in control of things. And really, it's those lumberjacks to blame for beating up Christian.
Now look at this, Jacoby Jones. Black Assassin out of the ring where he should be thrown back in. And the lumberjacks on this side of the ring not even touching him.
Oh, wait.
Oh, no. Are they setting up for something? Oh, wow.
Oh, my Lord. What a shot. What a shot. And Christian slumps over in pain. He might be unconscious.
Big boot right in the side of Christian Black's head. His head is propped against that ring post. So double damage done.
And look at that. His body's limp. And is that an opportunity for M. Freeze and Davi Jalisco and whoever to get in some cheap shots? Is that what they do?
And the other part of it, Jacoby Jones. Wait a minute. One. Two.
Is the foot on the rope? I believe the foot's on the rope. It's barely off the screen to your left there.
If you go all the way back, Jacoby Jones, to when that maneuver, that big boot in the side of Christian Black's head was put on, that move shouldn't even happen because he was outside of the ring. He should have been, as soon as he stepped out of the ring, been put back inside the ring. But those guys let him do that move, and man, oh man, the damage is done.
Well, some of these lumberjacks need to go to lumberjack school, if you ask me. And now Christian Black, he's conscious, that's good, trying to fight back with everything he can. A few shots to the midsection. There's a snapmare.
Christian Black showing some heart, fighting his way back.
Kicks him in the spine, trying to clear the cobwebs. Nice. Diving clothesline to a seated opponent, and both individuals are down.
Well, Christian Black got a little bit of momentum going his direction, throws everything into one maneuver. It was a big maneuver. It definitely did his damage, but guess what? It also did damage on himself.
Well, bought him some time, too, to try to recover from that shot earlier. But yes, I'm sure it took a toll on his own body as well. Both men trying to reach that very pivotal vertical base. Whoever can get there first will have a distinct advantage. Is it Christian? I can't tell from this advantage point.
Jim has got to back up a little bit.
Christian staggering.
Definitely woozy, but where's the Black Assassin? Oh, no.
There's a shot by the Assassin. Oh, and dives off the ropes onto Christian. Despite his enormously powerful frame, the Black Assassin has shown us over time that he's very agile as well, very skilled in the squared circle. And look at that. Christian caught the referee's hand. He knows every trick in the book.
Did you ever think, though, Jacoby Jones, that maybe, just maybe, the Black Assassin was home watching this and he sees Christian Black come out disguising himself as the Black Assassin, and maybe, just maybe, the real Black Assassin took offense to that?
The real Black Assassin. What does that even mean? Who is the real Black Assassin?
Well, if you ask the guy in the ring with a mask, he'd say he is.
Well, I mean, he emerged on the scene about 5 years after Christian first used that character. So I don't know. I have no idea. Oh, there's a shot. I have no idea the significance of that, though. Christian Black came into his own these past couple years in TWF. Huge impact on each and every show. Oh, and there's a splash. Nicely executed. Took some starch out of himself as well, sacrificing his own well-being to take out this assassin.
You said it right there, Jacoby Jones. Christian Black has to start doing more maneuvers that isn't so hurtful or impactful on his own body. He has to start doing things like kicks, punches.
and he wants to take out the assassin. He's seen his toughness. He's seen his ability to withstand just about everything over these past 9, 10, 11, 12 months. And look at this.
Mono a mono.
Nothing fancy about this. This is bad blood personified here at Real Mania, here in TWF.
This is what a feud looks like when it gets to the boiling point, Jacoby Jones.
Oh, look at Christian. Christian has reached his wit's end, and Christian is digging down deep to take this man out.
Definitely advantage right now going Christian Black's way.
Beautiful butterfly suplex, vintage Christian Black right there. But yes, he hold this cranium. He could be wrestling with a concussion. I hate to say that. In this day and age of cranial injuries, you don't want to say something like that, but the evidence speaks for itself.
Ask him if he knows where he's at.
Hey, what day is it? You know, what venue is this? What company is he working for? You know what I mean? These people definitely want to see Christian succeed. The Black Assassin was the first man to his feet, now with the shot.
Desperately urging Christian Black to come back to life.
Oh, I've seen this before. Pump handle.
Oh no, he hits it. Oh, it could be over.
Stuck him. Oh. How frustrated is the Black Assassin that Christian found a way out the back door?
A nanosecond away from three count, Christian Black somehow, some way, gets that shoulder off the mat.
Well, there's a reason Christian Black is cheered by the masses. He started out as a big-hearted referee, but he has earned the cheers of these people over the years by getting his butt kicked several times, but always coming back and always proving that he's a fighter. He's not going to put his tail between his legs and run out the back door like some other people I've seen. He's going to fight you till there ain't no fight left.
Both men to a vertical base. Black Assassin took way too long to come on the attack mode for Christian Black, but here we go.
Motivation. Pain is a terrific motivator. And look at Christian go.
Chokes and throws him in the corner, warns the referee just to stand up. Oh, wow.
The Assassin's on the outside. Christian might have used the very last of his energy to execute those last few moves. We've got ourselves a Donnybrook. You knew it. You knew it was just a matter of time. With this many volatile personalities at ringside, they're all going at it.
A slobber knocker, a pier six brawl, whatever bad hackneyed reference you want to use. But look at Casey McMurphy saying, hit me in the chin. Gladly abides the grudge, just M freeze.
The word on the street is Casey had a few cold ones backstage to rile himself up for this thing.
It's like an average Saturday night for him.
Yeah, he's going down to the Maple Room on Arden. Meanwhile, Black Assassin slithers back inside and is now stalking Christian Black. Oh, wait.
And I was going to say, how in the hell can the Lumberjacks throw people back in the ring and do their job if they're over fighting them with each other?
I agree. How can they? I don't know. I simply don't know. Some of these guys reluctant to put their hands on the Black Assassin. They've seen what a wrecking machine he can be when properly motivated. Oh, wait, here we go.
This could be the most chaotic Lumberjack match I've ever seen in my life. Oh, look at that.
Christian Black dives.
Christian Black seizes the opportunity, looks down, sees about 12 or 13 guys beating the snot out of each other, decides, what the hell, I'm just going to flip onto them all.
Taking them out like a bowling ball and bowling pins, excellently executed by Christian. But in this melee, did he take his eyes off the assassin? Oh, no. Oh, no.
And how much did that take out of him? How much did that take out of him?
Damn it. Assassin's Creed. And Christian is seeing stars.
Now is the opportunity. If the Black Assassin wants to go for the 1-2-3, this is his chance right here. One more maneuver, and I'd say Christian Black is over like last night's dinner.
No. Not like this. Christian has no idea where he is. The Assassin perched on the second rope.
Waiting for him. He got it.
Blackout. Blackout leaps off the ropes, grabs the cranium, grabs the skull, and drives it down all in one punishing motion. This is not good. Not good for Christian Black and anyone that that believes in him.
He could already be concussed, and after that maneuver, he could be on Goofy Street for the next 3 years.
Wow. What's the assassin doing? What is the assassin? This is the Lumberjacks. If both men are on the outside, what's their purpose? Do they throw them both in?
Well,
do they watch? I'm not sure what the hell's going on here.
Well, it's kind of a Mexican standoff between the Lumberjacks. First team's waiting to take another punch at the other one.
No. Oh, my Lord.
He just hurled Christian Black into those chairs.
He's out cold. It was Assassin's Creed on the damn floor.
Oh, my.
He's out cold. He's not moving. This is not good.
And no, absolutely no sympathy. He's wiping his feet, so proud of what he did.
The referee stopped this thing.
He could have ended the career of Christian Black.
Did the referee... Christian Black was unable to defend himself. Christian Black was knocked out cold on the damn floor. Your winner by knockout, I don't believe it, is the Black Assassin. They need to be careful when they're moving him. They need to stabilize. This is bad. We did not expect this to happen this way at all.
These guys are not EMTs. They're not out carrying like a sack of potatoes.
This is not good.
Maybe we should wait for a stretcher, fellas.
We need to call some medical professionals as soon as possible, please. Oh, and look at this. You got angry lumberjacks running at angry lumberjacks. You got a wrestler who was knocked out cold, deemed unfit to continue.
This is chaos. This is just broken out into absolute chaos.
Well, this is how competitive it is in TWF. Everyone wants a leg up on the competition. But the bigger story here is Christian Black's health. Is he okay? That was a vicious, and I mean vicious, Assassin's Creed finishing move on the damn floor. Dropped him face first, head first, on the floor. That's not a wrestling ring that he fell in. That was the floor.
Getting him backstage for medical attention.
This is, oh my God. This, you see the... I am at a loss for words. That did not end up the way that any of these people anticipated this lumberjack match to end up.
Except for the Black Assassin, I think it ended up exactly like you anticipated.
Wow. Expect the unexpected at TWF Live events. I hope Christian's okay. We'll have a health update next week, I'm sure. May 18th, Salvation Army Center, 893 Lander Avenue, Turlock, California. Doors at 6:30, bell time at 7. Food will be there. All ages welcome. A portion of the proceeds will go to the Salvation Army.
A very short trip away from wherever you are, I'm sure. You want to take the trip down to beautiful Turlock, California. I'm sure the weather's going to be great. You got a nice early bell time. Jacoby Jones, tell him not to miss it.
Don't miss it. Also, Tag Team Tournament, most unique show we've ever had, Friday, May 31st at FC Joyce School, 6050 Watt Avenue in North Highlands. It starts at 1:30 p.m., right when those kids get out of school for the summer. What a treat. Free, free, free.
Innovative. That's the key word in this one, innovative. Tag Team Tournament. You're going to see tag team after tag team. The action is going to be nonstop and wall-to-wall. And best of all, it's free.
Well, if you want to have a private party with TWF like that youngster did back in December, story of his life, text us at 916-317-9999.
How great would it be to have a bunch of TWFers in your house, breaking up your furniture, going through your refrigerator, huh?
Also, the official podcast of the Total Wrestling Federation, it's gaining more and more listens every single week, is Bugging Out with Jack and Black. Be sure to listen anytime you want at jackandblack.podbean.com.
Your kids are into your podcasting. This is a podcast you have to check out. Not only check it out, tell your friends.
Yeah, and tell your friends, if you want to learn the fundamentals of pro wrestling and then start wrestling on TWF shows, there is your ticket. Text that number, email us at TotalWrestlingFederation@hotmail.com. We'll teach you the fundamentals, then you'll have the time of your life.
Eat your Wheaties, say your prayers, lift your weights, and join.
Well, next week, it's been confirmed on this television program. Matt Fury versus Eddie Hernandez, two of the most technically proficient athletes around today, will duke it out.
That is going to be one that's going to be unable to contain in the squared circle.
Well, this is the part of the show I was dreading. Our friend, our colleague, our buddy, Dick Pearsall, has taken a hiatus from pro wrestling. I know you got a lot on your plate. I just wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you for everything, Dick Pearsall.
Wow. You're very welcome, Jacoby Jones. Let me just say, the last almost 10 years that I've spent here in TWF has been one of the greatest times of my life. I've made some great friends. I call them brothers. I would not replace a moment of it. There were some great times. Sweat, blood, and tears. But let me just say this to all the Twiffers out there. Jacoby Jones, you most of all. I might be taking a little bit of a hiatus. I might be gone for a little while. But don't ever forget, Dick Pearsall is always just right around the corner.
And all sorts of interesting weapons in mind for this matchup. Dick Pearsall. Oh, no. That might be the most interesting of them all. That is the bicycle. That is a bicycle for about a five-year-old little girl. Oh, face first, he goes into the stage. What is on the weirdo mind? What is on the interesting, simple, loving mind of Gilbert? You don't think? Really? No way. I don't think he's going outside to lock that bike up. What the? I do think. Here he goes! And Dick Pearsall cuts him off with a big clothesline. Just as he was about to get flattened by the little kid bicycle. One more time, sidesteps the trouble, hits the clothesline, and some little girl is crying her eyes out because her bicycle is gone. Get him, Gilbert. Don't waste any time. Knock his block off. Gilbert, turn around. You see what he did there? You see, you got in and he got out. Don't let him mess with you, Gilbert. Gilbert, turn around, please. Oh, and Dick Pearsall cuts him off as Gilbert's trying to get in the ring one more time. Drops a big elbow on the sternum, and despite the punishment that he's taken, an extremely good showing for himself. Oh, yeah, just as I'm about to put over the fact that Dick Pearsall has done something.
Oh,
Oh, come on. Just as I'm singing his praises and saying that Dick Pearsall is in the ring hanging with a former television and tag team champion, he rips some tape off his wrist and chokes out Gilbert. Yeah, real noble of you. Obviously, Gilbert, feeling the fatigue. Oh, wait, come on. He's had that Niner jacket since he was 6 years old. Come on. Oh, and choking him out with it. That's one dirty dick. Come on, that's from back in the days of Ronnie Lott, Jerry Rice, and Joe Montana. Maybe Dick Pearsall is a Rams fan or something. Now grabbing that ladder, the purpose of this match, despite all the insane shenanigans we've seen thus far, is to climb the ladder and grab the Butterfingers. And Dick Pearsall might feel that Gilbert is beat up enough for him to climb the ladder and win. Well, maybe not. He thought about it for a second. Whoa! Watch where you're swinging that thing, big man. They call that a water weenie? Oh, it's a hula hoop. I haven't seen one of those since third grade. Wow. Good hip work. I hear Gilbert was hula hoop champion in 1987. That's just an internet rumor. Is that a sword?
You're dead.
Go.
Oh. And Dick Pearsall cuts him off. Shot to the midsection. Now going after him. We're on the outside. Choking him? His neck's probably a lot bigger than your hands, Dick. Oh, he blocked it. Oh, all it takes is one big haymaker. Oh, from an individual and as large and as powerful as Gilbert is. Oh, rams him into the post for the second time in about 30 seconds. And Dick Pearsall might be seeing birdies or seeing stars or whatever you see on the outside right now. Is that a ball?
Okay.
Catch. Oh, forget barbed wire baseball bats. That's a candy baseball bat. Oh, we missed. He's soft core. He's soft core. Oh, and Dick Pearsall gets possession of the light purple baseball bat and takes some swings for the fences. Oh, looked like Buster Posey before the injury. Now both individuals are inside the ring. Gotta keep some fresh breath. Although it might not be the cleanest of Tic Tacs after sitting on that canvas. That ring's seen more action than Pamela Anderson in her heyday. More action than Tommy Lee back when he was relevant. Dick Pearsall trying to set up the shoot part of the chutes and ladders match. That's a slide. Meanwhile, though, Gilbert trying to grab the Butterfingers. Oh! Amazingly athletic display there by Dick Pearsall. Up the slide, up the ladder, and clotheslines Gilbert out of his shoes. Oh, stunner! Stunner! Well, look at this!
Dick Pearsall soars through the heavens like Michael Jordan. And now, oh, he's dangerously close. If he grabs, oh, wow, he's within inches. Oh, wait, Gilbert caught him. Gilbert shoves over the ladder, and Gilbert has Dick. Special Olympic slam, and down goes Dick Pearsall. Gilbert has firm control, offensive momentum, every reason to win this thing here and now. He's up the ladder. He did it. He's got the butter fingers.
Yeah.